So today I'm speaking to Professor Mark Ferguson, Director General at SFI, about how the agency is responding to the COVID-19 crisis. Mark, could you tell us a little bit about SFI's 5-point plan when it comes to dealing with COVID-19 and how successful it has been so far?
First, of course, we have our rapid response call for proposals. So this is soliciting research proposals that will address the COVID-19 crisis. And I'll speak about that a little bit further. Then, of course, we have problem curation. And that's been going very well, where we've been linking groups of experts with people who want advice. So, for example, within the HSE, people who are developing the contact tracing app, we've put them in contact with all kinds of experts who are on Bluetooth, looking at how the app might function, looking at societal acceptability, privacy, and so on, so that they can get a real expert input into that. Then, of course, the research centres from Science Foundation Ireland have been delivering. For example, iForum has been making protective equipment. Insight has been doing surveys. APC has been helping with reagent supply. And then in the early days, we provided a lot of curated information on our website, you know, where people could go. We then transformed that to link into other existing databases that sprang up as the COVID-19 crisis evolved. So we then stepped away a little bit from the individual curation and more signposted to reliable databases where people could get information.
So what response have you had to the COVID-19 research call from SFI, and why were these latest 11 projects chosen?
We received more than 500 applications to the rapid response call. Obviously, we announced the first wave of successful projects a few weeks ago. Today, we're announcing this wave of 11 projects. So what's happened is that these projects have all been sent out for international peer review. They've been looked at in terms of the excellence of the science, the potential impact, the relevance, and so on. And these have been selected from the group that were sent out, about more than 50 sent out. So success rate is somewhere between 10 to 20%, which means a lot of proposals we received have not been funded. And the proposals have been selected because they believe, the international reviewers believe, that these are state-of-the-art research, that it will contribute to our knowledge both nationally and internationally for managing the pandemic, and that will have a real impact into Ireland over the next little while. So if you look at some of the projects, you can see they range, you know, from supplying and helping to design protective wear for frontline health researchers, thinking about how you can have more flexible supply chains and repurposing of manufacturing going forward, thinking about how we could have better modelling for the next wave of coronavirus infections, those kind of things, front and central, and of course, antibody testing to see whether or not people have been exposed to the infection.
And how much of a challenge has it been to balance, obviously, the huge focus on COVID-19 research, but also on the ongoing efforts among all the other SFI centres and other non-COVID research?
It's important to get that balance right. And I mean, to date in Ireland, we have funded all of the COVID-19 projects by reprofiling money that we already had. There's been no new money allocated. Now, that's fine. That's actually what you should do in a pandemic. There's obviously an emergency and you need to respond to it. And of course, some of the things that we would have anticipated spending money on, like, say, sponsoring conferences and workshops, can't take place during a pandemic. So it's really a sensible thing to do. You know, we will be living with the virus for some considerable period of time. We need to understand an awful lot more, both about the fundamental nature of the virus, you know, how infectious is it? What is the infectious dose? What are these super spreaders? Can you identify them? Can we have better modelling for the future? You know, what can we do to have, say, a rapid cheap test so that we can move away from social distancing? So the good news is that the research community has contributed significantly to managing the existing crisis. The good news is it's very collaborative and sharing. There's no duplication, highly efficient, and that will be required going forward. And we'll have to add that research to the existing body of research that's ongoing. And then, of course, there are the challenges of actually the research community getting back into the laboratories. That is now happening. With social distancing, they're going to have to be doing shift work 24 hours a day because you can get fewer people into the laboratories, fewer people around machines and so on. So like all aspects of the economy and industry, so the research community is also going to have to adapt to working in these new conditions.
Well, thanks, Mark, for speaking to me today.
Thank you very much indeed.